We're told that triangle PIN is rotated negative 270 degrees about the origin. So this is the triangle PIN. And we're going to rotate it negative 270 degrees about the origin. Draw the image of this rotation using the interactive graph. The direction of rotation by a positive angle is counterclockwise. So positive is counterclockwise, which is the standard convention. And well, this is negative, so a negative degree would be clockwise. And we want to use this tool here. And this tool, I can put points in, or I could delete points. I can draw a point by clicking on it. So what we want to do is think about, well, look, if we rotate the points of this triangle around the origin by negative 270 degrees, where is that going to put these points? And to help us think about that, I've copied and pasted this on our scratch pad. So actually, let me go over here so I can actually draw on it. So let's just first think about what a negative 270 degree rotation actually is. So if I were to start, let me draw some coordinate axes here. So that's an x-axis and that's a y-axis. If you were to start right over here, and you were to rotate around the origin by negative, so this is the origin here, by negative 270 degrees, what would that be? Well, let's see, this would be rotating negative 90. This would be rotating negative, another negative 90, which would together would be negative 180. And then this would be another negative 90, which would give you in total negative 270 degrees. That's negative 270 degrees. Now notice, that would get that point here, which we could have also gotten there by just rotating it by positive 90 degrees. We could have just said that this is equivalent to a positive 90 degree rotation. So if they want us to rotate the points here around the origin by negative 270 degrees, that's equivalent to just rotating all of the points, and I'll just focus on the vertices, because those are the easiest ones to think about, to visualize. I can just rotate each of those around the origin by positive 90 degrees. But how do we do that? And to do that, I'm going to draw a series of right triangles. So let's first focus on, point I right over here. And if I were to, let me draw a right triangle. And I could draw it several ways, but let me draw it like this. So it's a right triangle where the line between the origin and I is its hypotenuse. So let me see if I can, I could use a line tool for that. So that's the hypotenuse of the line. Now if I'm gonna rotate I 90 degrees about the origin, that's equivalent to rotating this right triangle 90 degrees. So what's going to happen there? Well, this side, right over here, if I rotate this 90 degrees, where is that gonna go? Well, instead of going 7 along the x-axis, it's gonna go 7 along the y-axis. So it's going to, if you rotate it positive 90 degrees, that side is going to look like this. So that's rotating it 90 degrees, just like that. Now, what about this side over here? What about this side? Let me do this in a different color. What about this side right over here? Well, this side over here, notice we've gone down from the origin. We've gone down 7. But if you were to rotate it up, notice this forms a right angle between this magenta side and this blue side. So you're going to form a right angle again. And so from this point, you're going to go straight as a right angle. And instead of going down 7, you're going to go to the right 7. So you're going to go to the right 7. Just like this. And so the point I, or the corresponding point in the image after the rotation, is going to be right over here. So that green line, let me draw the hypotenuse now. Whoops, I wanted to do that in a different color. I wanted to do that in the green. I have trouble changing colors. All right, so there you go. It's gonna look like that. So your new point I, if you rotate this triangle, this right triangle 90 degrees, your new point I, or maybe I shouldn't say, I'll call it I prime, which is what is the image of this point after I've done the 90 degree rotation, is going to be right over here. And now we can do that for each of the points. We can do that for n here. Let's draw a right triangle. And I could do it a bunch of different ways. I could draw a right triangle like this. Let me draw it like this. So that's one side of my right triangle. Actually, let me draw the hypotenuse first. So I have the hypotenuse connects the origin to my point, just like that. And then I could either draw it up here, or I could draw it down here, like this. I could draw it like this. So if you rotate this 90 degrees, this side, which is 7 units long, and we're going 7 below the origin, it's now going to be 7 to the right, right? If I rotate it by 90 degrees, it's going to be right over here. It's going to be here. And this side, which has length, this side, which has length 2, it forms a right angle. So we're going to form a right angle and have length 2 right over here. And so the image of point N is going to be, let me get the right color, it is going to be just like that. It is going to be, the image of point N is going to be right here. I'll call that N prime. So we know where the image of I is, the image of N is. So now we just have to think about where does the image of P sit. And once again, we can do our little right triangle idea. So let's draw a right triangle. So just like that, I could draw that side, and I can do this side right over here. So if I were to rotate, if I were to focus on this, let me do this in a color I haven't. So if I were to focus on, I've already used that color. If I were to focus on this right over here, and if I were to rotate it by 90 degrees, instead of going 2 to the right, it's gonna go 2 straight up. If I rotate this by 90 degrees, it's gonna be just like this. Now, this side on, let me pick another color. This side right over here forms a right angle, and it has a length of 3. So we're gonna form a right angle here and have a length of 3. And just like that, we know where the image of P is going to be. It is going to be right over here. So this is P prime. And I know it's kind of confusing, but now we now have to connect the P prime, the I prime, and the N prime to figure out what the image of my triangle is after rotation. So let me do that. So if I connect these two, I get that. If I connect these two, I get that. And if I connect these two, if I connect those two, I have that. And there you have it, I have the image. And now I just have to input it on the actual problem. So let's see, point -3, 2. Let me get it out. So -3, 2 is there. I have 7, 2. So let me put that in there. 7, 2. And then I have 7, 7 is there. So let me get this out. So 7, 7, and then I'll draw here again to connect the lines, and I'm done. I've rotated it through an angle of 90 degrees, or -270 degrees, which is what they originally asked me for, and I can check to make sure I got the right answer.